here this evening as we do our, we can call this our first annual Advent service. But as we celebrate the coming of our Lord, I want to begin by reading a scripture and then we'll open up in prayer this evening. In the Gospel of Luke, chapter 21, beginning in verse 25, Jesus says, "And there will be signs in the sun, in the moon, and in the stars, and on the earth, distress of nations with perplexity of the sea and the waves roaring, men's hearts failing them from fear and the expectation of those things which are coming on the earth, for the powers of the heavens will be shaken. Then they will see the Son of Man coming in cloud with power and great glory. Now when these things begin to happen, look up and lift your heads because your redemption draws near." This is what the Advent is about, is the coming of Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Our Heavenly Father, we are so thankful that we are able to come together here this evening to celebrate the beginning of the Christmas season, to celebrate not only the birth of our Lord, but the fact that He has risen from the dead and He will come again. Father, we thank You for this opportunity to worship. And Father, I pray that it's a blessing to You and to everyone here. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
The meaning of the service. As we begin the Christian year, we also celebrate the holy season known as Advent. It is a time when we prepare ourselves for the coming of our Messiah. Advent means coming. We celebrate these days of Advent in expectation and preparation for Christ's arrival.
Through the centuries, Christians have observed a time of waiting and expectation before celebrating the birth of the Savior, Christmas. The Advent season is a time for reflection and preparation, but its mood is joyful. Advent has been enriched by Christian tradition to reflect its distinctive Christian meaning. It proclaims the revelation of God's love as it is expressed in Christ's birth in a humble stable, His sacrificial death on the cross, and His victorious resurrection. It points to the hope of Christ coming again as the King of Kings and Lord of Lords. Advent makes innkeepers out of all of us, asking each of us to make room for the arrival of Christ the King. Let us today prepare Him room in our hearts, our lives, and in our homes.
Yeah.
Christmas tree, along with which we also have the wreaths and garlands. The common thread among these is the color green. They traditionally come from a tree called the evergreen, so called because it remains green all year round, even through the winter. It is forever green. A tree that is green is a tree that is alive, and the evergreen represents life. Have you ever seen the greenery of life appear after the deadness of winter? The beauty of life is amazing, and that is what Christmas stands for. The Christmas season is all about life, life that is evergreen, life that is everlasting. This is brought about by none other than our Lord Jesus Christ, the baby lying in the manger that we proclaim this time of year. John 5:26 tells us, as the Father has life in himself, so he has granted the Son to have life in himself.
The one who is the source of life is the only one able to grant life to those who do not have it. Jesus said, "Most assuredly I say to you, he who hears my word and believes in him who sent me has everlasting life." This is what makes the dream of Christmas so beautiful. The fact that it exemplifies the abundant life that we have here and now through Jesus Christ, and also the hope of everlasting life. I hope you will remember this as you see the dream from here tonight.